Hello, welcome to the first episode of my Survival Minecraft series. This is a build focus series, and as you can see, I went ahead and I did all the preparation work so we can jump right into the building, and we're going to be building right out here. But I've gone ahead and I've done some resource collecting. So I've got my stone ready. I've got the three main types of wood that I'm planning on using in our first project. I picked this map out specifically for what we're doing because there's five biomes that I wanted specifically. And they're within about 3,000 blocks of each other, which is all right for what I want. While I traveled to where we are, I found a couple villages right next to each other, and I found my potatoes and my carrots, and I think I got my beets. Yep, I got my beetroots. I have my cocoa beans. I went ahead and got the enchanting station ready. Down here is just strip mining, and I have found 34 diamonds, and I also found a golden apple in a desert temple. I don't know if they changed how common they are. I'm using the snapshot 15W51B for Minecraft 1.9, before Minecraft 1.9. And so they've changed chests for loot. There's a whole bunch of stuff in the chests, and there was a golden apple in one of them. So that was pretty cool, because it used to be about one every 100 chests, I think, that you'd find an apple. So I've got my enchanting table ready. I have 30 levels. I haven't enchanted anything, so we can start off by seeing if we can get anything that we want. I'm going to need some lapis. I'd like a silk touch, and I don't really want to risk just getting an unbreaking 3, so let's make a sword. I wouldn't mind sharpness, because this is the combat update, and mobs are tough. They really are. Sharpness 3, I might go with that. Or we could do the pick and hope that there's something else on it. Or if it's just Unbreaking 3, we can combine it. I'll just keep using that. So we'll take our chances with this. And Fortune 2 is the last thing that I wanted. So I might just use this as a work pick. I didn't even get efficiency, but that's okay. We're at level 28 now, so we can enchant soon enough. I got my chickens and my cows here. I turned down the volume because they're really loud. If I turn them back up, yeah. So we're underground right now. This is just a temporary base. This isn't anything that I'm going to keep. And I don't even really like it. But down this way just leads to a bit of a tree farm right over there for my oak trees. But over here, let's sleep. Anytime. All right. Over here, this is where we're going to be building. Well, sort of. I'm eating raw potato. Let's put that away. There we go. I've gone and just touched up this area just to make it look a little nicer because it was kind of nasty. This is my first attempt at a custom tree that I did off camera, and it's all right. I ran out of leaves. I think it needs some more leaves, like right here and definitely back here. And then they got the new path block in this update, so I use that. I really like the, it's hard to notice, but I just really like this little indent that it gives a little bit of more dimension, and then you can just see some more colors that way. And over here, it looks like mud in the swamps, and then put down some plants so it looks nice and grown. This is a natural tree, other than some wood that I placed there. But this, I grew this, and I guess I'll keep it, but it's huge. But where we're going to be building is, let me turn up my render distance. Where I'm going to be building, rendering is really funky in this update. So it takes a little bit, but this is where our first build is going to be, and it's going to be a town. Right now I have plans for 5 towns or kingdoms, nations, whatever. And they're all, there's a sheep in my boat. They're all tied together by story. So it's kind of a story-driven builds. And the first town is going to be on water. So if you've seen The Hobbit, I think it's called Lake Town. Made mostly of wood, really kind of dirty. That's what we're going for here. And I have plenty of ideas already. Or if you haven't seen The Hobbit, like Riften in Skyrim, kind of like that. So we're going to get started. The first thing that I want to do is we need a bit of a plan for a layout of what the town's going to be. So we're going to base everything around paths, like wooden paths above the water, and I think I want to use oak. If anyone's wondering, I'm using the John Smith texture pack. I like the vanilla texture pack, but this one just has a lot more blocks that allow you to build with. A lot of the woods go together better. Let's see. Where do we want to... Most of this is going to be on the water. But I'm trying to think where I want to put a spot for it to touch the ground. There's land over there, but we have plenty of room here. I'm thinking just right over... Right here might be a good spot. And then just... get this tree out of the way. Just tear this down. Okay, we need slabs for what I want. So let's go ahead, get our crafting bench. And, whoops, there we go. All right, so if we're starting right here, I'm not going to worry about how it connects to the ground right now, but it's going to be a half a block up. It's going to be 3 wide. I'm wondering if maybe spruce wouldn't look better. Let's get our 3 types of wood that we're using and see what we like for the path. So we've got dark oak and spruce. That those 3 are going to be the main types of wood in this town. And the feel that I'm going for this town is that I want to be really tall and cramped. It's not supposed to be a rich town. I want to feel like when you walk in, you're surrounded by building. When you look up, you'll see nothing but 2-3-story tall. Okay, that was spruce. Get some of this. All right, so here's our 3 different wood types. So this is definitely not what I want. And actually, now that I look at it, I think I want this one. It looks kind of more weathered. So we're going to go with that one because it's the wood that's outside all the time. People are walking on it. So now I've got all these oak slabs. We'll find a use for them. So we're going with the spruce. Just go ahead. I've just started this and I've already got a mess of an inventory. All right. So let's just carry this out. So I'll finish this up, bring it out a little bit, maybe branch off a little bit, and then I'll get back with you guys and show you what I've got. All right, I've got a bit of a template here. I didn't extend this too far because extending this out, I realized that it's really not that far until you get out over there. If we ever need this area to be bigger, though, I think we could just remove like these little bits of trees and islands. And we definitely have plenty of room, especially if we branch out over there. But so I've just extended this out, and I put down these posts with dark wood on the bottom, you know, the old trick where it makes it look wet. And I think these are spaced 9. And right here, I think I'm going to put the just a little bit of a taste of how this town is going to look. So I'm just going to start on the first building. So let's see. We'll put this here to start with. And 1, 2, 3. Is that? Nope. Right here. And extend this down. So this town, it's going to be sort of like a fishing town. So that's mostly what they have access to here. They don't really have good land for crops. So for wheat and bread, they're going to have to get it somewhere else. So I think that's going to play a bit of a role in our second site of building and a little bit about how this town is structured. So at some point we're going to incorporate like docks and cargo and fisheries or whatever. And if it ever turns nighttime. Hello. I don't know how you're supposed to hit cow now. If you hit them, they go everywhere. I got him. And they push you around now. You can see I have Captain America skin. But I don't know if you maybe put carpet down if that would raise the block up high enough so that they wouldn't bounce over it. But that one also looked like he got on top of a ladder. So I'm not sure what the most efficient way of doing this anymore would be. Probably not having them in such a small spot. But for now, that's what works. Nope. Alright. Nighttime. And I waited just long enough so that some bad guys will be out there for me. But I don't... Ah! Yeah! I missed. Got him. Got him. Okay. We need to make some sort of path here eventually, because walking through those vines and water isn't the best way. All right. So I do have an idea of what I want this building to look like, and it's going to be two sections like this. We're just going to build one side of the wall to start with, whereas normally you'd build the corners and then put the walls in. So, right there. Okay. And then we're going to need, let's try oak wood. And... pull this out. Did I get this wrong? This is four. Yes, I did get this wrong. I think I want this here. Yes, I do. All right, let me just fix that. Since we're down here, we can just bring up the other one. Let's break this because I don't want to place it on a block that isn't the lowest. There we go. Yeah, if I can get up. All right, wrong wood. This one. All right, so we got space of three there. We also got this one wrong. Remember, kids, builds and odds. Build and odds. Builds and odds. I'm having a tough time. Okay, so this part's going to have a path coming up to it. Let me just lay down the wall real quick so you have an idea of what I'm actually going for, and bring up this, and this one as well, and this wall is also going to come out to there. Ugh. Second try is charm. Third try is charm. Yep. Got it. All right. Let's see. We should have a window there. Well, let's worry about that once we have the actual structure. All right. So we're not going for really small houses, and we're also not looking to make huge, intricate houses, but these should allow for a decent bit of detail. So now I want the second floor to be brought out a block. It would be interesting. Right, first, All right. Whoops. I'll remove that later. I think I would like... Let's see, this needs to have a floor underneath it. Like that. And then let's pull it back behind here so we can walk back here if we need. All right. Okay. So let's put window there. And then, I wonder how it would look if, do we have any stairs? We don't. Let's just make some, let's try something darker that would complement or stick out from the lighter wood there. What if, so these are pretty tall buildings, so we shouldn't be afraid to use the height. You'll see what I'm going for here in a minute. Let's just get up here. And 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And how's that look? What if we brought this down 1? It's right there. No, I don't like that. So we'll leave that there. This one I think could be here. And then maybe that kind of deal. These could maybe be stairs, but we'll get to that kind of detail later. I think I want there to be a one side higher than the other, like a tower. And this side's already taller now that I've placed that there. So, see if we have a way to get up. Okay, so let's put in the wall here. And do we want it here? Or do we want it set back? I think it'd be too flat there. So let's set it back. And let's just say that this one has a tall window or something. So, darn it. So I kind of like how that is. So already you get kind of the feeling. You walk in here, walk into the city, and then imagine a similar building on the left side. They're kind of closing in on you, look up, and you can see a little bit of the sky poking out, but you're just going to be surrounded by buildings. So I like how this is. So maybe if we have one taller than the other, maybe this one can have a roof already, just after one floor. Let's extend this floor. I need some more half slabs of the spruce variety. Come in here. and something is giving me a bit of FPS hits, so I'll just bring this down a little bit. We're not looking out there anyway. Another thing, do I have fog on? I like to have my fog close. Is that a... That might be a... Optifine thing. Because... I bet it is, where you bring in the fog. And they, last I checked, they didn't have Optifine for this version yet. Maybe I should have checked, because I'm getting a little bit of choppy frame rates. But it's nothing too bad. Okay. Let's just cut this out, just because we know we don't need it. Maybe we can fit something decorative in there, like a bookcase. I'm not sure how far out we're going to bring this. I also want there to be multiple levels to the city. So, like right here, maybe we're going to have a pathway going up, and then there's a walkway up here or something. We'll see. Let's go nap. Before it gets dark. They've included new sounds in this update. And right before I started recording, there was a witch. And I could not figure out what it was. Until I found it. All right. I missed one. Let's just throw this in. Oh, we're not at 30 yet, so we can't enchant yet. All right. So, for this entrance, I'm thinking that maybe we can do this in an episode or two. We put up a guardhouse that's on both sides, and it's got a walkway over it. I think that would be a good entrance. I've got ideas for special buildings other than just houses. Do I want this all the way out there? It'll be pretty cramped if I don't. I think that's fine. And I think I want this to be 7. I do. So here we're getting the 3D shape. Let's get our post out. Okay. So right here. I have all these tree farms because this is going through a lot of wood really fast. I have one over there, and you might have seen, you can see right there I have a spruce tree. Those are just growing for me to cut down. So if I bring this up, and then bring this out, although I do want that floor under it. Yeah, and this, well, you know what, we can mix up the shape a little bit, go up here and do it, and bring this part in, so... So if the house was shaped like this, and then this would be a post, this would be a post, where am I? All right. Right there. And let's... I don't want that. Let's fix this while we're down here. And then right here. Okay. And there you get a bit of an idea of the size of the house. I think I want to bring that out. This one right here. And then remove this. Put my floor back. Okay. Right, and then do we have more oak? Well, gonna need more. So yeah, I like that. This is just a small, this can be a bedroom maybe. So I'm gonna work some more on this building off camera, and then I'll show you either the finished result or whatever I end up with. So see you in a bit. All right, this is what I've come up with, and it's not done yet. I gotta finish up the tower up there, and there's some detail things. The interior isn't done, but this is about what we're going for. I put a little post here. Maybe we can put a banner on it. I don't really have a source of wool other than that guy right there. And that guy. But, I did add a bedroom. I put a couple bookcases. I need sand for glass. So we need a lot of stuff. And I'll probably, like, build a bunch of these houses and then maybe go through on a decorating episode or something. And we can get up to the second floor. I don't have way up to the third floor. But, yeah, that's what we're looking at right now. This episode's running pretty long, but it was our first episode and we spent the first 10 or 15 minutes just talking, but that'll about wind it up for us today. Tomorrow or whenever the next episode goes up, we'll be looking at making another building probably. So until then, see ya. What da do, da da do, da da do.